What is up, creatives? This is Tom. Today we're jumping straight into Final Cut Pro X. I'm going to be giving you some tips to speed up your editing workflow. Keyboard shortcuts are bread and butter for any video editor. So here are some killer useful ones that I've found since switching to Final Cut Pro. First of all, if you're zoomed in, whack Shift Z and you'll be zoomed out so that the whole timeline fits your screen perfectly. Pressing Command 6 when clicked on a clip will open the color correction panel for that clip, and pressing backslash will loop that clip so you can see your corrections in real time. Super useful for color correction on the fly. If you want to delete a clip in your primary timeline, but you don't want your timeline to snap, pressing Shift plus Delete will replace that clip with a gap, no snapping required. Clip connection can also be useful so that you can move audio associated with a clip, but I find I actually need to move clips without connections more often, so hitting this weird button that I don't know what it's called will temporarily disable clip connection. Adding audio keyframes can take a really long time on a project, and often for a simple bump in audio volume, you'd need to add 4 separate keyframes. Final Cut Pro has a built-in way to do this, which is way quicker, and it's called the Range tool. Hit R on your keyboard, select a range of audio, and just drag. Now you're going to have a perfect audio bump that fades in and out. Crazy useful shortcut they're going to be using all the time. One of the biggest complaints I had about Final Cut when I switched editors was just how thirsty it is for storage space. After a bit of playing, I basically found out it's because Final Cut has this habit of copying everything into a library file, which for an organized editor is kind of a bit silly. Be on top of your files, keep them organized in a file structure on an external hard drive. And a really quick fix for this one, just open Final Cut's preferences, go to import and check leave files in place. Top and tail is an editing technique that's only been available within Final Cut for the last few years, but it's just so helpful, so it's a huge win that it's been incorporated. By holding Option and hitting either the open square brackets or the close square brackets, Final Cut will cut your current clip and delete what's between your playhead and the next available clip in the timeline. This feature basically saves you 4 clicks and keyboard presses, as it's something you're going to need to be doing hundreds of times in a project that definitely adds up. I should probably say stop color grading first. This one isn't Final Cut Pro specific, but it is an editing mispractice I've been guilty of in the past. Best practice is to leave it until the end, where you can actually grade only the clips you'll be using. Instead of spending time grading clips you end up not using in your final edit. There we have it, guys. Hopefully that is some useful tips that you can take away from this video and speed up your editing in Final Cut Pro. Let me know if you'd like a similar video on Premiere Pro, which I did use for about 7 years. If you want to see the video on why I switched, you can do that down below in the description underneath the like button, or drop a comment down below and we'll have a chat about video editing in the comments, and I'll catch you next time.